Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa kafa wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulihil mustafa sayyidina wa habibina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa mawala. Brothers and sisters, the month of Ramadan is the month of everything. As we said, it's the month of ibadah, month of Quran and hidayah. It's a month of barakat, blessings. It's a month of mercy, rahmah. It's a month of maghfirah, forgiveness. It's a month when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chained the shayateen, suffidat the shayateen. It's the month when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the doors of paradise. Futihat abwab al-jannah. Wa ghulliqat abwab al-nar, the doors of paradise being closed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are so happy in the month of Ramadan. And we are trying to do every possible thing in terms of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there is one thing I want to remind myself and all of us, that the month of Ramadan also is a month of family. It's a month that we had to turn our mind for a moment, thinking about our own family and our responsibility to make sure that us and our family will be safe from the hellfire. Remember the ayah in the Holy Quran, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Ar-Rajim. Ya ayuhal ladhina amanu, all believers, qu anfusakum, protect yourselves, wa ahlikum and your family members, an-nara, from the hellfire. Allah is very openly, very strongly reminding us to do every possible way to protect our family from the hellfire. And the word qu comes from the wiqaya. It means protection. It means early measure. Take every possible step to protect our family from the hellfire. In other words, brothers and sisters, it is very important, number one, for the parents to build an awareness, be aware about the responsibility here in this dunya and in the hereafter. How many parents are regretful in this dunya? In time that the kids are becoming rebellious, they don't want to listen. They say harsh words, even bad words to the parents. And then the parents begin to realize that they didn't take the responsibility. They didn't take the responsibility. They didn't educate the children. So the way the children talk is just like anyone around. But for us Muslims, we must educate our children how to behave to the parents. وصينا الإنسان بوالديه حملته أمه وهنا على وهن وفصاله في عامين أن اشكر لي ولوالديك. But in order for our kids to be obedient, to be dutiful and kind to the parents, it means also parents must be responsible. That is just it is very clear. In order for the kids to be responsible, parents must be responsible. It gives an example of Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. Remember when Ibrahim came from Jerusalem down to Makkah al-Mukarramah just to tell his kid Ismail that indeed I have seen in my dream that I'm going to slaughter you? When he said, "Fanzur madha tara," so think, what do you see? How do you see about this? And his child, Ismail, did not say, "Are you crazy, Dad?" He didn't say, "You never come before to give me anything and now you are coming to slaughter me." What Ismail said to him, "Ya Abati, oh my beloved dad, if alma tu'mar, do whatever commanded to do. Whatever Allah commanded you, do it. Satajiduni insha'Allahu min as-sabirin. You will find me insha'Allah among the patience, to be among the patience." That is a responsible kid. But why he is responsible kid? Because of the responsible parent. Ibrahim and his wife Hajar alayhi salatu wasalam had taken the responsibility very seriously. So the result, he found a very responsible kid. So in order for us to have a responsible kid, we must take our responsibility to educate our kids here in this life. So in the month of Ramadan, use this opportunity to educate your kid. Ask them to read the Holy Quran, ask them to pray Taraweeh, ask them to make zikr, ask them to do fasting, ask them to istighfar, ask them to learn how to behave in the month of Ramadan. Because that is really the purpose of Ramadan, as the month of education. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all and strengthen our faith and give us tawfiq. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.